How's it going, everyone? This is Ivan. As you may have heard, Elon Musk said that one of the ways to make Mars habitable is to drop nukes on its poles. Now, is this idea any reasonable? Let's find out. Why would we want to nuke Mars in the first place? Well, because right now it's quite a harsh place to live. Martian surface temperature vary quite widely, and that is due to the fact that Martian atmosphere, which is composed mostly of carbon dioxide, is very rarefied. The pressure at the surface is 160 times less than on Earth, and so this kind of atmosphere cannot store the heat. If only there was a way to increase the pressure. In 1784, William Herschel was the first to discover that Martian polar caps actually vary seasonally, just like ice caps on Earth vary seasonally. And so people thought it might be ice water there as well. Much later, in 1969, NASA's Mariner 7 successfully photographed Mars during its mission, and scientists found out that South Cap is at least several meters deep and, more importantly, is very cold. That was a strong indicator that the cap consists of carbon dioxide. And so the idea was born. We drop nukes on poles, they evaporate, massive greenhouse effect is created, the temperature rises, all is well, right? Not quite. Later discoveries found out by Mars Express and Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter in the early 2000s revealed that actually caps consist primarily of water, with only a thin layer of carbon dioxide on top of it. In fact, there is 12,000 of cubic kilometer volume of CO2 at South Pole, which sounds like a lot, but this is actually only 80% of present atmosphere. So even if we managed to evaporate all known CO2, it wouldn't even make the atmosphere twice as dense as it is today. But that's not the biggest problem with this idea. This is the Tsar Bomba, the AN-602 hydrogen bomb, the most powerful nuclear weapon ever detonated by Soviet Union in 1961. It is almost 3,000 times more powerful than the Nagasaki bomb. It could wipe out the entire city of Paris. But how much of carbon dioxide could it evaporate? I did some estimates to figure this out, and my calculations show that even such a monster would only evaporate 0.25 of cubic kilometer volume, and so we would need around 50,000 Tsar Bombas. Do I even need to say that this is completely infeasible? So in the end, it turns out there's little point in nuking poor Mars. Maybe we should nuke some other planet instead. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe. And hey, don't forget to stay curious.